Steve Clinton has asked how to paint ancient armor. So in today's video, we're going to show you how to do that. But first of all, you'll need to undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Zandri Dust, but you can pick whichever color suits your army. After that, we'll start base coating. For this, we'll use Lead Belcher. We'll then follow that with a shade of Agrax Earthshade. To get some cool grimy effects, we'll use Typhus Corrosion, then highlight back up with Stormhost Silver. And then for the rust, we'll use Scrap Brown thinned down, and then finishing off with Nylock Oxide. So let's start basing. So first of all, let's get that Lead Belcher out of the pot. Just going to use a paintbrush of Lead Belcher and just a little tad bit of water. So probably just a paintbrush of water, actually, just to give it a bit more control when you're applying it to the model. So make sure I've got enough on my brush, and then I'll just start applying it. We're just going to focus on the shield for this video. So we'll just start applying it on. If you see some of the Zandri dust showing through, just do another coat after. Once the Lead Belcher's dry, we're just going to apply Agrax Earthshade with a medium shade brush. We'll do this all over the shield. Once the shade's dry, we're now going to apply Typhus Corrosion. There's two ways to do it. Just concentrate in the recesses, or like I'm doing here, dab it on and then wipe your finger. You could use a bit of tissue paper, but I prefer to use my finger. With the Typhus Corrosion applied, we're just going to use a little bit of Stormhost Silver just to pick out some of the raised areas. Don't go too mad, just pick out rivets and things like some of the teeth, like bits of the skull here. As you can see, it's starting to look a bit grimy in those recesses as well, which is what we want. With the highlight now applied, we're just going to thin down Scrap Brown with 3 parts water and 1 part Scrap Brown. We're just going to apply this into the recesses, and it'll give it a cool rusty effect. With the Scrag Brown now dry, we're just going to apply Nylock Oxide in a few key areas, and we don't need to go too mad with this, we just want to be a bit selective. Keep it around rivets and some of the deeper recesses. And there you have it, the ancient armour is now done. So I hope you found that useful, Steve. Keep sending those requests in, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.